The design thesis, Productive Insurgents Readdress the Tragedy of Commons, by proposing a network of shared resources as a model for the contemporary urban context. Imagine if you see this massive building develop a little by little each time you come to your home. It is getting bigger and bigger with each day attacking the neighborhood you grew up in. How do you feel when you remember that land used to be the playground you played cricket with your friends? And it is where you saw a beautiful Vesak Torana, a musical show, or a Christmas carol program with your family. The government and private investors had transformed it beyond recognition. Then how can we welcome the new neighbors happily to the community? Good afternoon, everyone. I'm Lahiru Fernando, and let me elaborate on how I established a new model of commons in the imagined urbanity to conserve shared resources within a community by transforming a demolished common into multiple productive commons, dispersing them around the neighborhood and link them to a main productive backyard. The commons are simply referred to as natural and cultural resources shared by many people and accessible to all members of society. While tragedy is when individuals with access to a shared resource act in their own interest. This tragedy is addressed by Garrett Hardin by proposing two solutions, government regulation and privatization. The same two solutions acted upon the mentioned land and demolished every valuable cultural activity. Based on the writings of Elena Ostrom, this economic and political theory was interpreted into architectural characteristics through a literature review in my final year dissertation. Simultaneously, a public survey with nearly 120 participants demonstrated the users' perception of commons and the qualities they wished to experience in commons. This process proposed a third place that brings all the involved parties together for the benefit of the community. This third place indicates that a network of shared resources can provide more to the community than replacing former neighborhood commons. A railway junkyard located at the backyard of the neighborhood is considered to initiate the productive insurgence. Starting from the town center, the road that leads to the neighborhood passes Vadu Public Library, Public Market, Post Office, Fish Market, newly developed Sea Breeze Apartments, then Samudra Rame Temple. Railway station and tracks act as a separation between the commercial and residential zones of the context. The solution occupies three major sites for the creation of a street promenade. While the railway junkyard acts as the site for the key intervention, the road leading to the site creates the required link and exhibits the new commonality. The road lies within the newly created edge is used as a supplementary site to reach this edge. The third place acts as an R-urban facility by providing beneficial elements such as grow spaces, an eco-hub, and a recycle lab for the community. Secondary site is used to exhibit each component of the scheme in the context. For this purpose, 8 straight-down small plots were selected and repurposed into introduce several types of commons that can be adapted as new commons. The proposed interventions start from the Vadu Public Market as a system application to uplift the existing market frontage by providing new stalls that follow the main site systems. In the event of Sunday Fair, the expansion can create platforms for small-scale vendors and the entrance for the polar. Intervention number 2 is introduced to connect the two zones separated by the railway tracks. This creates the railway station square and the entrance to the main site while providing the created pockets to the vendors and Sunday Fair. Intervention number 3 focused on reconfiguring the existing gardening plot maintained by railway station staff. This provides new facilities to the existing plot, such as exhibitive greenhouse spaces, raised beds, and a creeper vegetation skeleton attached to the pedestrian bridge goes towards the Samudra Rame Temple. Intervention number 4 renovates the existing extension of the fish market by introducing 6 modules to the government-provided structure. As in the public market, this creates the other end of Vadu Pola. Intervention number 5 reconfigures a garbage dumping land in the neighborhood into a bike sharing facility. It is initiated by extending the existing bike repairing shop while introducing a new public pocket. A beneficial module for both the new and old residents is proposed in the main social node as intervention number 6. It provides a tea shop, a newspaper stand, while attaching a trellis system to the developed boundary for the new housing complex, vegetated with essential herbs. Intervention number 7 was placed in the newly created edge to bridge the old and the new. The abandoned building of the nursery school is reinstated as a kids' library space while creating access to the kids in the new housing complex as well. The link created by these micro-interventions leads the visitors and the residents to the main intervention, the productive insurgents. The introduced program connects the entrance public area to the beach park through a production zone, making the collective production a part of the public space. To produce a productive shared resource, the identified characteristics of commons were converted into design principles. When typology A invites the user to occupy the provided plots for their need, typology C focused on producing a model of production-driven spatial design which can tie up the user's activities to the building.
It tactically converts an underutilized land into an ideal shared resource by using the know-how, time, and participation of community members.
First, the existing gardening plot of Sunday school children of Samudarame temple was selected as the initiation and expanded towards the other part of the site. The existing building of the former railway quarters is used as the main farmers market to distribute the product from the gardening plots. A service tower as an observatory is introduced to the site to provide the necessary services for future activities. Recycle lab and eco hub are introduced to the site, adjoining the existing hard edge created by the strip of hotels. The common, the main element of the project, which is consisted of a community kitchen, community dining area, and meeting spaces, is introduced along the mentioned hard boundary. The rest of the land, which acts as the neighborhood's backyard, is provided for the community for collective grow spaces with four greenhouses. At the same time, an experimental greenhouse pavilion will be introduced by the merchant actor. Then the farmers market is expanded with the community food bank, distribution center, and a produce item section. Then the top part of the site is assigned as the entrance public space, creating a bridge towards the railway station square to receive the visitors to the neighborhood. Then an exhibition green pavilion is introduced between the growth spaces, allocating the kids' educational garden for the Samudarame temple and the other one as an exhibition open plot. This completes a pathway which takes the visitor from the entrance square to the beach park through the social activities introduced with exploration, production and consumption activities, giving the impression of productive use of a shared resource. While the whole site operates around productive community activities, the built systems try to provide an open public structure to bring people together to grow, prepare, consume, explore and learn in their own neighborhood. At the beginning, the common will be more or less a naked structural grid which gives the users freedom to be a main part of the transformation. All community members complete the initial naked structure, allowing the structure to become a shared space and involve parties to achieve the collective ownership of the new common. Community participation extends, transforms and completes the life of the common, which is a symbiotic relationship between the commons and its users. Eventually, it tries to provide the shared resource, attaching these activities to the built space and even assigning the built elements as productive commons for the community. For example, the required air gap for the upper floor vegetation is continued at the ground level with a screen vegetation element as a part of the hollows of the foundation, which is used to store nutrient reservoirs and distribute nutrient solution to the upper floors. Used two systems in collective grow spaces are integrated into the facades as well. A screen grow box is introduced to the facade to demonstrate the protected growing systems. A traditional drip system irrigation method completes the naked structure, making it an exhibitive facade. The blue and red grow lights used for the plant growth create the ambience of the internal spaces, while the visibility of the diffuse light through the translucent polycarbonate sheets makes up the facade towards the community. While the built elements, built spaces and introduce activities to connect different actors together demonstrate the principles of commonality, this model of new commons illustrates that the solution for the tragedy of commons cannot be just black or white.
Therefore, with this intervention, a model to protect shared resources within the community is introduced. The thesis established a Communal Property Act for Sri Lanka with the developed tripartite governance model. It further formed an index, a framework, a scoring criteria and the model of tameness to measure and assess whether a shared resource is truly a common for all.
This new common, the third place, provides the demolished practices of commons back to the community with more opportunities as productive commons, assuring them that the commons are to be kept and protected within the community through the created collective governance model. Thank you.